regional honours. It is Japan versus Australia. From Tokyo, Shuhei Tsuchiya. 17 fights, 15 victories, and 13 of those have come via the short route. Leni Zappavigna, our very own, stands the other side of the ring. 32 fights, 30 wins, 20 inside the distance. Zappavigna, a former IBO lightweight world champion and an IBF world challenger. 1 year separates the two, a slight height advantage for the Japanese, reach advantage for the Aussie, absolutely nothing on the scales when they weighed in 24 hours ago. Let's go centering to Perry. It's semi-final time.
Semi-main event of the evening, ladies and gentlemen, for the WBO Oriental Light Welterweight title. Introducing first, fighting out of Inuyama, Japan, please welcome Shuhei Tsuchiya. Opponent, ladies and gentlemen, fighting out of Leamington, New South Wales, please welcome Leonardo Zappavigna.
You'll see Leni Zappavigna and his team tonight wearing commemorative T-shirts. Leni's sister-in-law, April, passed away in December. A huge fan of Leni. And tonight, Leni and the team dedicate this fight to her memory.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you all please be upstanding for the Australian and Japanese national anthems. Thank you. semi-main event of the evening, ladies and gentlemen, live from the Melbourne Pavilion for the WBO Oriental Light Welterweight Championship. 12 by 3 minute rounds. When the action begins, our referee in charge is Mr. Dave Hitchcock. Firstly, to my right, fighting out of the red corner, ladies and gentlemen, trained by Shingo Suzuki from the Cardor AB Gym. Official weight, 63.3 kilograms. Standing 5 feet 7 inches tall. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, wearing the white shorts with the blue and green trim. Fighting out of Inuyama, Japan. 17 fights, 15 wins, 13 by way of knockout. Please welcome Shuhei, the Samurai Dynamite, Tsuchiya. And his opponent to my left, fighting out of the blue corner, trained by Tommy Mercury from Westside Boxing and managed by Michael Tamura. Official weight, 63.4 kilograms. Standing 5 feet 6 inches tall. Tonight we're in a black short with a bronze trim. Ladies and gentlemen, the former undisputed IBO lightweight champion of the world. 32 fights, 30 wins, 20 by way of knockout. Fighting out of Leppington, New South Wales, and representing Australia. Please welcome Lenny Zappavigna! Fighters, two centering, please, for final instructions.
Okay, guys, both know the rules. Talk about them in the rooms. That's what I call. I want to say it's a break. I want to break. I want to say stop, stop. You understand? Let's have a good clean fight.
Eyes on tonight. Not only that man, Lenny Zappavigna, also his opponent, Shuhei Tsuchiya.
Timekeeper.
Arrived.
Okay. Let's go.
In from Tokyo, Japan, with one thing on his mind. It wasn't a holiday to Australia. There are many good judges that think Tsuchiya could well walk out of here with his hand raised in victory. Zappavigna, though, goes in as favourite. It is Zappavigna in the black, Tsuchiya in the white. Venue that Zappavigna has been to before, not a lot of success despite a last up victory here over Reven Cesare. Got off the deck in round number one to post a points victory on the Caparello green undercard, but it was a victory that many thought that Reven Cesare deserved on the night. A super talented youngster. Wonderful bloke outside of the ring, Lenny Zappavigna too.
Yeah, I second that. And look, it's good to see Lenny down at light welterweight against Cesare. Was up at welterweight. And I think this is the best weight for Lenny. Doesn't have to hurt so much to get to lightweight. And look, he'll have his power here at light welterweight. Both guys look good early on. Oh, there's a right hand from Lenny.
Yeah, it was long. It was straight and powerful. Well timed too from Zappavigna in fight number 33 in his career.
That's what we said in the open. You see the low left hand of Tsuchiya, and Lenny can land that right hand over the top, but that's the one he's got to watch out for. Tsuchiya's got a beautiful right hand himself. He really drives down on the knuckles. Nice work from Lenny.
Doubling up the jab there, Tsuchiya.
Yeah, Tsuchiya, very confident young man. Walked in dancing and having a bit of laugh and a look around.
Oh, he walked into a nice lead left from Zappavigna over the top with a third punch right.
Watch the heads.
Very nice combination. They were crisp early from Lenny Zappavigna.
That was good to see. He would come in low, he went high, and he still had all his balance there. There he goes again. Well done from Tsuchiya to knock Lenny off balance. It's that right hand that Lenny has to watch out for. Tsuchiya already got a bit of a red mark around that left eye from the right hand of Lenny.
So too Zappavigna with markings over his left eye.
Oh, nice right hand over
to. Good countering right hand from Zappavigna.
And again, there's another one. And Lenny can see that right hand now, the low left hand of Tsuchiya as he digs down to the body.
And it's those body shots that are going to drop the left hand of Tsuchiya even further, opening up laneway and that right to go down. Last couple of seconds of this opening round, now semi-main event. corners we go. Two guys with very decent power at light welterweight.
Good boy, you're doing good. Listen to me, Lenny. You've got to double the jab. Don't get excited. You've got 12 fucking rounds. 12 rounds. You understand me? You've got 12 rounds. Come in, okay? Listen to me. Hey, you're here with a hook, bang! But please, don't be stupid.
Tommy McGurry in the corner, also with Vito Gordiosi.
Stay where you are for a second.
Ready, Tommy, guys, out of the on. West side of boxing at Levington in Western Sydney, has been with Lenny Zappavigna from day one. Former amateur superstar Lenny. Been to Melbourne, knows the place well. He represented his country at the 2006 Commonwealth Games just down the road.
Oh, a nice body shot. Come over the top. Zappavigna.
Lenny last out October of last year. And we saw his defence get tested. Knowing what Lenny is like, knowing what Tommy is like, that would have been their primary focus over the summer months.
Yeah, and you heard Tommy right at the end of that first round, Lenny caught a few shots on the gloves, and Tommy acknowledged that. That's what we want to do.
Speaking of amateurs, the national amateur titles and Commonwealth Games selection coming up in Western Australia next weekend. Good luck to everyone competing, and in particular to the crew from my local gym, the NBO, with Bryce, Casey, Abby and Elena. Led by the grand old man of Queensland boxing, Israel Carney, who also turns 48 next week.
48.
Happy birthday, Iz.
Happy birthday, Izzy. Well, we're on happy birthdays. Let's throw a quick happy birthday home to LJ Wattups. He turns 18 today.
So compact. The elbows up nice and high. The forearms stiff.
I like Lenny at this weight. Nice body shot. Look at that. Work to the body he's been doing early. Lenny's marked up. Tsuchiya.
Don't hold the hand. Come on.
Going for the body there, Zappavigna. Both guys really marked up. Swollen up around the eyes.
Yeah, good double jab by Lenny. And that's those little gloves. You know, and they're both landing left hands and both had a little bit of success with that right hand as Lenny has another success with the right and the left hook.
Don't hold,
do these light welterweights look like straw weights compared to what we've seen all night so far?
They certainly do. Lenny looks the stronger fighter here at the moment in round number two. Yeah, we've seen some big boys here tonight, that's for sure.
One more time, I'll take the point off. You understand? No more holding. Fight on.
Doubling up the left hand, Zappavigna.
And he marked up under the right eye. We'll give Tommy McCurry Spoon a good workout in the corner.
Zappavigna edging forward there to end round number two. 2-0 to Lenny, perhaps. How are you seeing it around Australia? World, we've got our first Japanese Oz boxing hashtag Yoshizawa. Because of the language difference, I'm not sure what he's saying, but I think he's loving it.
He's saying, let's go. Oh, left hook from his man, Tsuchiya. So far, this is a different fighter to what we saw in October here last year. Leonardo Zappavigna certainly looks good physically, looks strong at this weight.
He does, doesn't he?
Yeah, defences are better. He looks focused. Whilst he's marked up a little.
Very structured above the waist. Oh, he's been opened up, I think you'll find, Leonardo Zappavigna, over the right eye.
You know, as this fight goes on, if Lenny doesn't get a cut, then something's pretty rare. He does cut a fair bit, as Tsuchiya's cut as well from a head clash, I think, on the right eyebrow.
Zappavigna working hard from the inside.
Yeah, speed
and a good long right hand from Lenny. Happy to fight inside or outside. And that right eye of Zappavigna cut over the top, but marked severely underneath. And the cut and the blood flow, perhaps more importantly, from our Japanese visitor, Shuhei Tsuchiya.
I miss what Lenny's was from, but I'm pretty sure Tsuchiya's come from a head clash.
See if we can identify that through the referee and the judges at the end of the round.
Lenny aggressive.
Watch the heads.
Nice head movement from Lenny.
Watch
good to
heads,
see.
As the year goes on, is the idea of Lenny Zappavigna and Jeff Horn, light welterweight, appealing. For many outside of the ring it is, whether it is to the Zappavigna and Horn camps, I guess we may well find out.
Yeah, I agree. Well, one of them has to change weight. We've got Lenny here at light welterweight and Jeff at welterweight.
Welter.
It's mouth-watering.
Stop. Step back. Fight on.
Some would say no benefit in fighting at catchweight.
Well, no benefit for those, I guess, but good benefit for us as fight fans. Oh, nice shot, Tsuchiya. Beautiful underhand right uppercut.
Found home, didn't he? Throwing the better punches at Zappavigna. I think he's dominating on the scorecards. That's just my opinion, but certainly not having everything his own way.
No, that's right, I agree 100%. And there's a left hook from Tsuchiya. He's certainly got some skills.
Stop. When I say stop. Break, fight on.
Last time we saw an import rally back was just a few weeks ago on the Gold Coast with Damien Super Hooper bumping into a Korean that just couldn't and wouldn't say no.
Into round three.
He won the crowd over the Korean, didn't he? Let's have a look and watch the heads come together. Oh, there's the head clash. It's proof of what that cut was from.
Zappavigna. And also Tsuchiya, sporting war wounds. Tsuchiya's cut above the right eye, the inside of the right eye, is in fact above his eyebrow. Rarely do you see it in such a position.
Yeah, it was Tsuchiya's that seemed to be more of the problem. Oh, nice right hand from Lenny in round number three.
Punches a bit higher.
Lenny's doesn't seem to be bleeding too much, which is a good sign for the Australian.
Round number four.
Oh, good shot from Tsuchiya, but Zappavigna comes back and there's another right hand.
Oh, Lenny just popping the jab out and Tsuchiya eating every one of them.
Lenny's got a bit of a different posture. Oh, right hand from Tsuchiya. Really warming into a good fight here at the moment.
We have got a fight, haven't we?
Yeah, Lenny looks to me like he's changed his style, his posture a little bit, whilst he has the same aggressive style. Just sees his back's a little straighter as he lands a good right hand.
Over 5.5 months since Lenny last fought, does ring rust in activity become an issue? We may well find out in the latter stages of this contest.
Pretty professional lad, Lenny, so well, my guess is that he'll have that worked out, but he's got a good opponent in front of him that'll think otherwise.
Certainly not scared of Lenny, that's for sure, Tsuchiya.
Oh, heads might have bumped again.
Not surprising the way they are charging in and as active as they
are. Watch their heads, both fighters.
It's good to see a good work rate and a good pace in a fight when you get, you know, these smaller guys who have got the speed and the power. Although two of us has got plenty of speed and power, we'll see up next. Good jab, doubles it up, Lenny.
Yeah, beautiful. And doing so from a distance.
That all comes down to the front foot. Just a little step forward, just gives you that little bit extra reach to get in. There it is. Oh, big shot.
With the confidence in Lenny's actions and reactions, we've now seen Lenny drop that left hand.
Yeah, I think he has to be careful that he's doing everything right at the moment. He doesn't want to get caught with the right hand. You'll see when Tsuchiya throws that, he drops that knuckle right on. He's got to be very careful he doesn't get caught with that, Lenny.
Zappavigna doubling up the right hand. Oh. And a left hook from Lenny Zappavigna. It drops Shuhei Tsuchiya.
Fight on.
Oh, quick count as well. There was only a couple in that.
A very quick count. Back to the corners we go.
Oh, I thought we only got to three or four. Be good to have a look at that. Having success in round number four, but it was Lenny Zappavigna who finished with the left hook. Oh, flush on the button.
A peach of a shot.
Good balance, transferred the weight. And that's the outcome for Lenny Zappavigna.
And I don't think Lenny actually got him with all of it.
Stay in your corner.
It's a good sign.
We continue on our semi-main event in the light welterweight division. 63.5 kilos, 140 pound, or right on 10 stone. It is Australian Lenny Zappavigna in the black trunks. And Japan's Shuhei Tsuchiya in the white. Tsuchiya down in round number four. It was with the left hook. Is that where Lenny goes here in round five? Not initially. Aiming his offense at the body, trying to lower the elbows of the Japanese visitor.
Oh, left hook again from Lenny Zappavigna, and Tsuchiya is in trouble. Although he stands there, still right in front of Lenny.
And when we say right in front, we do mean it. He is going nowhere fast.
Yeah, and he's coming back now.
Fight out, come on, put you up.
Lenny really using his left hand to set shots up, which is setting up that left hook and the right hand. There it is there.
Both guys really marked up.
You can see why. Both guys really landed some good shots throughout this fight so far here in round number five. Tsuchiya keeps coming over. Oh, good defense there from Tsuchiya. Has the right hand stuck to the chin. But he keeps sliding to his left with that left hand low. And that's why Lenny keeps getting
don't
over
hold,
top with
hold,
that right hand.
Step back, don't hold. Fight on.
Smart work from Lenny and his trainer, Tommy. They've spotted that early. We'll see Lenny try and come over the top with the right hand here.
Want some good shots, hasn't he, Tsuchiya? So to Lenny, for that matter.
Keep the punches up a bit higher.
Doesn't quite have the speed and the zip in his punches at the moment, the Japanese fighter, but this is the reason why.
Oh, Lenny's power looks very good here tonight. Tsuchiya is taking
here
punishment.
Here we go. They are just standing there going shot for shot.
Stop.
Look at the right
step
eye
back,
of Tsuchiya. It's nearly closed within a 10-second barrier.
It has popped right up in the last half a minute, the right eye of Tsuchiya. Left hook by Zappavigna with 30 seconds remaining in the fifth.
Good body work from Lenny. He's marked up a little under, or cut a little under the left eye as well.
At times, this has been beautiful to watch as a boxing match. We've just seen a face-punching contest against the ropes between the pair. Oh, ouch! Zappavigna with that left hook again. It's on tonight.
So's that one.
So to the right bowler.
Lenny enjoying himself.
And they touch him up at the end of the round. We're back to the corner.
Something Lenny's not really known for is the left jab. Look at that, one, two, three. Beautiful work from Lenny. There it is again, setting up the power shots. Oh, right uppercut, and Ada left hook himself.
Second out, seats under, white mark, please.
Both guys, it seems, happy to take one to give one. That alone you have to admire. Round number six. Tsuchiya came in as the underdog. First trip away from Japan. Always a huge test in itself. Lenny Zappavigna had, so far, one of the more polished performances of his career. A little bit of everything, despite 5.5 months out of the ring. There were questions pre-fight about ring rust. Would it work for him, or would it have been a freshen up and really worked for him?
Yeah, I agree.
At this stage, he looks great.
Oh, he eats a right hand from Tsuchiya.
And another
big shot. He may have Lenny on the back foot.
Oh, Lenny Zappavigna busted right open. It looks like he's been punched by Edward Scissorhands. There is a huge cut underneath the left eye of Lenny Zappavigna.
Lenny showing good whiskers, but
box on.
That right hand from Tsuchiya has just opened Lenny up. Now on the other side.
Zappavigna strikes beautifully. And again, they go shot for shot.
Plant the feet. No one's taking a backward step. Oh, Lenny might have hurt him with the left hook.
This is brutal. And Zappavigna, front foot fighting.
Watch the heads.
What an absolute war.
Everyone with a white shirt within four rows of ringside covers up as best they can, because the claret is flowing freely. Zappavigna double and tripling up on the left hook.
Stop.
Changing
Don't
his shots.
Okay.
Varying his
on.
Levels. Alternating angles.
This is amazing. Good body shot from Lenny. Right hand from Lenny over the low left hand of Tsuchiya.
Watch the hedge. Don't hold.
How much more can these two dish out? And more importantly, how much more can they take?
Both guys taking plenty in this round. And he swings wild. Look at the right eye of Tsuchiya.
They continue to slug away. The venue a little quiet. I think most sitting here in awe, in disbelief at what we're seeing.
Step back. Step back, don't push. Step back.
The light welterweights on a heavyweight card. And this is hard-hitting, brutal boxing.
Up the back of the head, come on.
Work to do in both corners.
And we're only halfway there. Six rounds down, six remain.
That's a healthy shot in the left eye, cheek of Lenny. Not sure what the doctor's doing. He hasn't been caught in. The cut's under the eye. Tommy will soon fix that. Well, what a round of boxing. Both guys, ample shots. There's the right hand that's cut Lenny under the left cheek. And there, resembling a bloodbath, Lenny Zappavigna on the front foot, the aggressor. At that
seconds
stage
out,
anyway.
Seconds out. Clean up the seats, just there. Stay in your corner, clamp this area, please.
They couldn't quite stop the flow of blood from the left cheek of Lenny Zappavigna. Temporarily it stopped on Tsuchiya.
The cut of that severity under the left eye of Lenny will take a few rounds to get that under control as Lenny lands some good left hands and again, doubling it up. That's one thing that's really improved in Lenny Zappavigna.
Shots underneath the eyes of Lenny, caused by punches, not head clash.
Those guys going to be sore.
Tsuchiya is now starting the round as the front foot fighter, as the aggressor.
That's where Lenny's good. While Tsuchiya's on the front foot, that's when he's dangerous with the right hand. He really brings his body weight over and drives down on the shot. Ooh, the head's bumping.
Oh.
Look at that eye. Tsuchiya. It's from that left hook of Lenny Zappavigna. There's a left rip, left hook.
Amazing from Zappavigna. Tap, tap, tap down low. Then he waits for the opening high.
Tsuchiya did not take one step backwards.
Watch the heads. Watch the heads. Come on, get the
pump. Ripping to the body, Zappavigna. A red river flowing down his chest. Whoa.
What about this for a fight?
Unbelievable.
Oh, there's that right hand whisking past the left cheekbone of Lenny.
Those punches up.
Left hook from Zappavigna.
Don't hold. Break. Stop. Let go. Step gap. Fight on.
Two guys that Lenny Zappavigna has been beaten by. Ahmed Diaz in this very venue. And also Girl Vasquez. But Zappavigna not thinking about losses, thinking about victories. And importantly, victory 31. He opens up on Shuhei Tsuchiya.
Tsuchiya's got some ticker on him.
Fight out of it, come on.
He got put back on his back foot against the rope. Under a bit of pressure, probably a little hurt, and he plants the feet and goes with some of the power of Lenny Zappavigna.
Stop! Break up, fight, let's go. Watch the heads, guys, come on.
The Japanese fighter just so tough, so resilient. He is mirroring what the Aussie is doing. Oh, the body shot, that hurt. Tsuchiya.
Right, step back.
Both guys to hold on as they deserve. Back to the corners and the battle.
The bucket, come on out, let's go. Let's go.
A war of attrition. It continues. We're only in round number eight. Both guys look and probably feel like they've competed for 80. That's the entertainment excitement value. Not only has it been heavy hitting, Chris, it's high-paced as well.
Yeah, good pace, good speed, good power. Good entertainment.
Oh, big shot from both guys. Right hand from Tsuchiya, right uppercut from Zappavigna.
Zappavigna trying to crowd here. Gets in tight. Throws his bombs, all scoring shots for Zappavigna at the start of that combination.
Oh, doubles the jab again. Lenny's done that. There it is again, three and four of them. As he eats a right hand, the left hook comes back, his own right hand, his own left hook. Tsuchiya storms forward.
And Zappavigna as the counterpuncher on this occasion.
Outstanding.
He's been the initiator for the majority, Lenny Zappavigna. And it's back footing here and also talking to Tsuchiya.
Tsuchiya, for the first time in a few rounds, his cut reopens.
Come on, fight out of it, fight out. Come on. Okay, break, stop, stop, stop. Step back. Fight on, let's go.
Both throwing the big bombs still.
Both guys showing good chins, good whiskers. Only nods.
Nods and retreats, Tsuchiya. Happy to march forward, but any time Japanese fighter marches forward, Zappavigna content to bring him onto his shots.
How both guys are on my feet still at this time, I have no idea. It's not as if both of them are short of power. Lenny asked him how good it was, and there's a killer.
Two free left hooks from Zappavigna in the last 15 seconds that surely
break, stop,
have
go,
rocked,
go, stop,
hurt, and
stop,
slowed
stop,
the stop, momentum.
Stop, fight.
Shuhei Tsuchiya.
Oh, left hook from Tsuchiya, and it was Lenny going down for the rip.
Tsuchiya now with that right elbow protecting the rib cage. As a result, the target zone high. It's available and open.
And his eyes usually bleeding. Both guys go for the left hook. That cut's getting worse under the left eye of Lenny Zappavigna.
Stop, step back. Step back. Fight on.
Lenny's mouth's wide open. Is he getting a bit tired? He won't give up, I'll tell you that much.
Zappavigna with a poke of the tongue. Maybe it was exhausted. The tongue just wouldn't go back in.
Seconds out, let's go. Seats under.
Is it about game plan or is it just about looking inside yourself and finding that little bit extra?
Yeah, I think game plan's gone. I think it's all heart and determination. Now both guys literally stand in front taking their chances.
Don't hold, break.
That's smart words from the corner of Tommy Mercury. He saw what that left rip did to Tsuchiya. He wants Lenny to throw it non-stop. So far, he hasn't thrown it this round. It's the left jab doing the work from Zappavigna. Is he setting another trap for Tsuchiya?
Has Lenny Zappavigna made hard work of this? He's now fighting and has been a different fight to what he did in the opening three or four rounds, certainly taking nothing away from Shuhei Tsuchiya.
Yeah, I think you've got to give credit to Tsuchiya there, and it's just the style Lenny is. He loves to fight, and no matter what, win or lose, he's always in a good fight.
Tsuchiya now stalking. How much are the judges looking at the ring generalship and what's happening and who's aggressive? Oh. The three ringside judges are Tony Moretta, Anika Williams and Alan McColl. Can we go 12 rounds of this?
Well, keep it up somehow I don't. We may end up there. I don't know how. But the power and the shots that these guys are landing, there's enough to knock out every man in the room. Left rip from Leni Zappavigna, the shot that his trainer wants.
Don't hold. Break. Step back. Don't hold. Fight on.
Middle minute of round number nine. Zappavigna with an 8-2 record in his last 10 fights, 5 via knockout. Would love to make it 6.
Punches a bit higher.
He's got one of the best techniques on a left rip you'll see in a fighter, Leni Zappavigna. So Chaya, not too bad himself. Oh, nice, fast combination. They fell short,
but
good speed from the tornado from Tokyo.
Inside the final minute, round number 9.
Lenny been doing plenty of sparring with Chuck Mundine for his fight on Wednesday night. Also former Australian lightweight champ Val Borg. Certainly getting some good rounds in.
Using his jab well here is Tsuchiya, who has won the admiration of the entire crowd here at the pavilion.
Oh, left hook, right hand.
Zappavigna is wobbling big time and is struggling back to the corner. That was a heavy-handed two-punch combination at the end of the round from Tsuchiya.
Another absolute cracking round. Both guys having plenty of success. Round number 9. Defenses are gone out the window. Tsuchiya nearly knocks himself off his feet.
And both boys beaten, busted and bruised somehow find the energy to get up from their stool, look one another in the eye again, shape up and get it on.
3 rounds to go and Lenny really took his time to walk back to the corner in round number 9. He's got to keep his defences up, don't get caught by any of those big shots. He's on the back foot again.
Right, stop, let go of each other. Watch the heads, both fight on.
Enough head clashes, says Dave Hedgecock. Watch your melons, boys. We don't need any more.
Punches up, Lenny.
Zappavigna in close range, busy from the inside. Right eye of Zappavigna, shutting and fast.
There's a quick look up at the big screen to see how he's going.
I think he's probably looking at the clock and I can't fault him for that.
Oh, Sotea's gone.
Tsuchiya has hit the deck. Round number 10.
3, 4, 5. You okay? Hold your hands up. Put your hands up. Walk towards me.
They okay, are calling it. The red corner is calling it. The towel is coming. To Leni Zappavigna and to Shuhei Tsuchiya, we say thank you.
What an absolute Bobby Dazzler. Leni Zappavigna, unbelievable. Took plenty of punishment, gave it out. He stood there round number 10. And his hand will be raised. Tsuchiya.
credit to him as he gets to his feet.
Tsuchiya is on his feet, back to the corner, assisted he goes. Neither of these two boys is going to be modelling for any front covers for the next 7 days. They will wake up sick, sore and sorry. But wow, they have provided us with another fight of the year candidate.
Definitely. There's no sugarcoating this. It's a bloodbath. It's a war. But it's cracking. And it was a delayed reaction. Left hook from Lenny Zappavigna. So Tsuchiya actually lands one himself. Tsuchiya. There's the left hook, but he eats one. And it's Lenny Zappavigna who has the chin to stay on his feet. Here's the young man here from Tokyo. Lenny with a killer instinct to finish it off.
And the towel coming in from the corner. Amazing. Lenny Zappavigna, victorious. He makes it victory number 31-21 inside the distance. Let's go center ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dave Hitchcock puts a stop to this contest. 1 minute and 21 seconds into the 10th round. Your winner by TKO and the new WBO Oriental Light Welterweight Champion from Australia, Lenny Zappavigna.
Lenny Zappavigna, there'll be a few stitches required as he gets a kiss from his trainer and longtime mentor, Tommy Mercury, dedicating tonight's fight to his sister-in-law, April, who passed away in December. What a moment. Our semi-main event is done. That leaves one. Up next, the heavyweight eliminator final. It is Michael Kirby and Ty Tuivasa live on Fox Sports.